In last week's weekly Shonen Jump magazine, we had a preview talking about that there was going to be some Bleach news that, of course, is going to be huge that we should be on the lookout for. And of course, as the community of Bleach always does, they just, for some reason, go, Hell Arc, Hell Arc, Hell Arc, movie, without actually using the brain. So, what was the actual news that Shueisha kept telling us is going to be big and something we don't want to miss out on? Well, we're going to be talking about that in today's video and talking about why I personally love this more than people may think. But that's fine. That's why I'm here, to give you a perception or perspective that you may or may not have heard of. So with that being said, hit that like, hit that subscribe, all that good stuff to be caught up on the latest up and coming Bleach news. And of course, the best analysis around when I actually do them. And without my voice breaking, let's get into the video, shall we? Are you tired of those very big companies that license your favourite series and decide to drop merch with just a copy-pasted manga panel? Well, so is the Bleach community. Because my friend and fellow YouTuber DBZ Imran has dropped Getsuga.com. Getsuga is a clothing brand specifically attired to you, the fans, and the Bleach aesthetic, that rather than just copy-pasting a manga panel, has in fact blended and perfected the amount of Kubo titles, poetry, and manga imagery. Currently, the website is promoting its Undead collection with just over 20 days to get, with two of my favourite designs personally being the Undead, with that really cool slash effect right through the text, and the best, in my opinion, the Blade of Fate. Each of these designs have their own relevance towards its respective chapter and the character that it's resembling. These designs and material hold quality, as well as community feedback, so please, show your love, because I really need that Ruruka collection, guys. Check out Getsuga in the description down below, and let's get right into the video. Now, as I said, we're going to get some big news on Monday in Weekly Shonen Jump magazine. However, the news did get dropped by the Bleach Animation Twitter account themselves. And of course, it is what we all expected it to be. The 20th anniversary of the anime that aired in 2004, coming in and having that special event. Not to be confused with the 20th anniversary of the manga, which was, of course, in 2001. This is specifically for the anime. So, of course, what are we going to do in regards to an animation anniversary? And, of course, to much of people's disappointment, it was, of course, an anime exhibit. Now, of course, we've already had a manga exhibit that spanned for, like, 2 years, and people kind of cheered when it kind of was over because, oh, you know, we can kind of cross an exhibit out the way. We also had a Bleach Brave Souls exhibit. We had a Bleach Thousand Year Blood War Core 1 exhibit. So it was kind of like, cool, we can kind of cross exhibits off the list of things we could be potentially getting. Oh, no, 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 no. How foolish of you. Now, before I get into the complaints, I just want to talk about what we're going to be getting first and foremost. So if you would like to join me to my screen, which is going to be here. So, of course, this is the website. This is the Bleach 20th anniversary website, and it's called the Lotus of Brave, or the Brave of Lotus, something like that. And, of course, as you can see the Bleach X coloured versions of the, what was it called, the monochrome of, like, the 100 and something odd characters. So this is really cool to see, nonetheless. But there's quite a lot of things here, and some are more interesting than you may actually think. Because trust me, this goes a little bit deeper than you actually might think it does. And as someone that saw the magazine scan as well, it said that yes, there was going to be an anime exhibit, but there's also going to be more projects later on as well, which the website elaborates on anyway. The TV animation for Bleach was broadcast from 2004 to March 2012, and a total of 4 theoretical versions have been released so far. Interesting choice of words, no? So far? So far. I always like to nitpick these specific words, so far. Yeah, it's possible that there could be more, basically saying, like, it's, so far. It's not a statement. Anyway, this marks the 20th anniversary and the 3rd season of the final chapter of the anime. That is wording I don't particularly like, because I do believe there'll be more. So I'm a bit like, eh, but it depends on how they want to market, you know, if they do more outside of Thousand Year Blood War. Anyway, nitpicking words again. Bleach Thousand Year Blood War is scheduled to end 2024. To commemorate the 20th anniversary, a special project that transcends the boundaries between the original work and the anime has started. What can transcend the original work and the anime? Like, that's interesting to me, because an exhibit is not doing that. Like, the only thing that can transcend it is doing something better than both, in or give a new experience to both. So I'm very interested to see what they have in mind in regards to this. I know people will go back to the old Q&A of Kubo saying that, like, he would love a rebroadcast or a remake of the old anime, considering, like, he'd be more involved. And maybe that has something to do with that. You know, being very, very optimistic, you know, we could look at the One Piece thing where they do the specials of certain arcs, right? And they're kind of more condensed, but more, like, kind of detailed in its own right. But again, that's been a little bit optimistic. So I'm very interested, and I'm not going to really give my thoughts and feelings, because to be honest, I do think there's more. I really do, because at the bottom here is that this event will be at the Yokohama Landmark Tower, a special event with lots of exhibitions, product sales, and more. What is more? Please tell me. And the event period starts from April 26th, so literally next month. So we're going to get some really interesting things. And this is what I mean. People, when they saw the Weekly Shonen Jump magazine scam, when they saw this, they saw an exhibit, they doom posted. Understand that when Shueisha Market, they do multiple different things in a short succession of time. So this is the first of many things that's going to be happening. And again, I understand many people are disappointed because they're in the West and they can't experience these things. But I'm also going to kind of go on a little bit of a conspiracy theory shortly in this video. So please stick around, because I have some thoughts of where this is probably going to be going. And then as we scroll down, we have an S-Boss card collaboration. Now, granted, I don't really know what S-Boss is. I'm not going to lie, you know. But their Visa debit cards, I want one. Either the Ichigo one or the Chibi one. I think the Chibi one's kind of cute, but I'm thinking the Ichigo one is pretty kind of badass, right? It gives some information about that. You know, to have collaborations with Visa cards in general is pretty fucking OP. To get, like, a exhibit in a very well-renowned building, quite big too. This is not money that is just been, like, cheaply being spent. Like, this is pretty big. Streaming new anime Bleach series TVer/net will also be distributed all at once on TV Tokyo. A total of 203 episodes are selected from the TV anime. Basically, no filler. And that might include episodes with in-canon filler. It depends, right? The final chapters of a series, so basically the Thousand Year Blood War as well, and will be distributed all at once on TV Tokyo from March 25 on these networks. So please, and then it kind of gives you the link here. Interesting one. Okay, this is massive. Regardless of what you think, you know, think outside the box, not in the box, outside the box. All right, following Tatsuya Kitani's Eternity, which was an amazing PV, by the way, one of my favorites, I would argue, slightly, again, as a song, slightly better than Scar. I would argue that, right? Visually, I mean, it has all the spoilers in there, so of course I'm going to prefer that, but it, I mean, it's a great AMV. But that was released just before the Blu-ray was, and we're hoping to kind of get a new music video before the second Blu-ray dropped, which we haven't got yet. But the second music video project for the Bleach Millennium Blood War special tie-up with Senna Rin's Reaper, which was a candidate song for the ending of the first season. Awesome. Senna Rin, we got our baby back. We're going to see what was the candidate. I bet you the second choices for both of them are going to be better than the first. Not to say that the first picks were bad by any means. I grew to love Senna Rin's song, and I grew to love Scar a lot, but who knows? Maybe Reaper's going to be a great ending choice. For Anime Japan of 2024, the fastest release of a large monitor at the Aniplex booth, so please come and visit us. Now, please think about this. There's going to be a booth, there's going to be some Bleach promotion, there's going to be Bleach at Anime Japan, which means, as well, without a core date as well being given to us, they're probably saving all the core date, all the core information for Anime Japan, because, of course, what's the point in kind of giving, like, a special event to, like, a series where all the information or all the news is out there? So I feel like a lot of the news about the core has been deliberately, like, saved for Aniplex. Anyways, we would have got it a lot sooner. So gonna get the core date, probably some extra info, Senna Rin's music video. That's a good half an hour of the panel time that usually you would get at Anime Japan. So that's really good. So I guess I can probably confidently say we're gonna get core news at Anime Japan. Right, that's the date you're going to want to look at. We'll live stream it. We'll talk about it. It's going to be a good time. So, yes, and that will be on March 23rd. Do I stream or do I go? And then we have the line stamps, right? Continuing from the first season, we've decided to produce line creator stamps for. People in Japan love line. People love their stickers, and it works, and it sells. I don't know what to say to you. Like, whether you guys think this is big or not, in the West, you probably don't care. In Japan, it's big. At the end of the day, this is all marketed towards Japan. It works. It gets money. This is why the Bleach Expo exhibit like took 2 years, because it was just so successful that people just kept coming, and they didn't stop coming. So they just kept pushing and kept doing more, and they did a nationwide road trip. So, I mean, you can hate on them all you want, but it gives Bleach money, and that's good for the Bleach economy, so to say. So, and then it says at the very bottom here, other anime 20th anniversary projects are underway. So, you know, the exhibit's already out there, right? We got a music video, we got Anime Japan news that's going to be coming, we got streaming, we got line stamps. What else is there going to be underway for the anime? And this is big. Now, the reason why I say this is big and why this is interesting to me, and as much as I don't like the company Viz, I think they're just very questionable at most times. You tell me, again, you have to look at this from a different perspective. Why are Viz promoting, one, this isn't a new key visual for Bleach at all. This is quite old. It's one of the first. In fact, right, this is quite new. Well, it's not new, but like they've never posted this. But why would Viz post about the 20th anniversary on a promotional level? Two posts, mind you. Why would Viz post something about the 20th anniversary if they're not going to do anything about it? Because they haven't done this with the event. It's not like they did it for the Bleach X, right? They never did it for the manga. The only thing that Viz did was like, oh, we did this 20th anniversary volume 1 new edition, and that was it. They didn't promote the exhibit, obviously, because it's not Japan. Begs the question to me why Viz are getting involved and also putting their trademarks as well on this poster. You see Viz at the bottom. And they're doing it on this one too, putting Viz in the red. It begs the question why Viz are putting their trademarks on these key visuals and what their involvement is going to be. And Viz basically only sell anime and they sell manga. Are we going, this is where my brain gets ticking, and this is the conspiracy theorist in me, is that are we going to be getting something anime related? If so, what is it going to be? And I don't want to say a movie, because I know that, you know, the team is hard stretched as it is. So I'm more begging the question towards maybe an OVA of maybe like a data book one shot, right? Of like Isagi visiting the grave of like, what, you know, Tozen, or like you have Okiura's backstory with like how he became Vasto Lorde. I'm kind of like shooting examples here. I don't actually know. Or maybe it can be something like Safui or the Honey Dish Rhapsody, right? It can be those things. These are things that would kind of transcend or complement the original anime if they use the old logo and they use the old art style and they kind of give it that, like, what would you call it? A type of memorial? Not a memorial. I can't think of the word for the life of me, but something nice for the old anime. Something, you know, keeping that aesthetic while also complementing it. Because I don't really understand why Viz would also get involved within the anime. It's not going to be manga, because this is anime specific. So I wonder what Viz's part in this is. But yeah, I'm honestly really excited. I mean, shit, is it gonna be a game? It could be a game. We already know that there's two games in the works. One's being Soul Resonance, which is still a project that's happening. But also, we also believe that there's another, obviously I've known that there's a console game that's been in the talks and in the works for like a long time. And there was a new like IP, I believe, of like some other Bleach game. I'm not quite sure. Only time will tell. So there's a lot for Bleach going on, and I've already said like many times on Twitter or X that Bleach has a future, and all we can do is just like let them cook. I don't think that the community should doom post all the time and just let things happen, because what you're going to see is some great long-term marketing happening, and this is only the start. And we've had like 4 or 5 things given to us already. Whether you think it's big or not, is regardless, because we got some exciting things to come out of it and some things to talk about. So tell me what you guys think in the comment section down below of what you think of these news, as well as what you think of the future. I want both opinions on both things, what we have and what we will get, because I do want to hear your opinion on what this means as we have right now. That being said, I'm going to catch you my focus later. You guys, of course, have these fine Debbie and Hanson. As always, people, peace out.